What's up, Star Wars fans? Welcome to a slightly sneaky little episode 7 of Star Wars Go Figure. Wasn't planning on doing a podcast today. It is Friday, the 2nd of November, and that is also the date of my birthday. It is my 31st birthday today. Having a nice relaxing day away from work. I booked the day off months in advance. So I'm just having a nice quiet day at home, which has been pleasant. I'm just watching Revenge of the Sith. I've just paused it just to get up and stretch the legs a little bit. So I thought I'd chuck the microphone on and just have a little bit of a chatsky. It's been a good morning. I got spoiled rotten by my wife. She looked after me. She got me some cool stuff. I'll show that off in a minute. I'll talk about it in a minute if you're listening. So if you're watching here on YouTube, you'll be able to see it. So that was pretty exciting. Got a pretty nice weekend ahead. After a pretty chaotic week with work, I've been quite exhausted lately. Work's really starting to pick up and get busy in the lead up to Christmas. We're only 8 weeks away or something, which is ridiculous. I feel like it was February about 2 weeks ago. But yeah, having some fun outside of work is important, and making the most of my downtime is very important this time of year. I tend to take my birthday off every year. If it falls on a work day, I tend to just book that day off and just have a bit of day for me. Last year, my wife was able to take day off work as well. So that was really nice. Unfortunately, this year she couldn't. But that's okay. We'll spend some time together over the weekend, and that would be nice. And yeah, anyway, I just wanted to share with you a couple of things my wife got me. She got me some really cool gifts. Firstly, you can see it on screen here. It's the Black Series Darth Vader helmet. I'm really damn excited about this thing. It looks sweet. It just fits on my fat head, which is cool. But it's a really nice box. The box is awesome. Excuse the dogs. They're inside. They want to talk too. The boys want to jump on the podcast. Don't know what they're barking at, but they want to join in too. They want to talk Star Wars. They didn't like the Vader helmet much. They weren't sure I put it on, and I sat down next to them, and they weren't sure who I was. But they're okay. There's one of them now walking past. But yeah, it's a pretty nice helmet. I'm really into it. I've only ever gotten the Kylo one beforehand. I'd like to get the Stormtrooper. Well, I've got the EFX Stormtroopers. I don't really need it. And I was very tempted to get the Poe Dameron one, but it never eventuated. I never really picked it up. I'm sure they're still around somewhere for a reasonable price, so maybe one day in the future. I don't really have a lot of space for, you know, big items like that anyway, but I'll make room for the Vader helmet, because that's sweet. She also got me another gift, which was very lucky. This one I sort of asked for. She always asks for some ideas, and then she tries to get me something that off of her thoughts, but you know, it always helps to have some ideas, especially when it comes to Star Wars stuff. And it can be hard to buy for a Star Wars fan when you don't know what they've got. And I tend to buy a lot of stuff with my own allowance anyway. I give myself a bit of an allowance, so I tend to get what I want anyway. So I put a few feelers out for a couple of the new Lego sets, and she's gotten me the Imperial AT Hauler from Solo. I'm just going to hold the box up there. And this is a pretty damn awesome looking set. I can't wait to pull it open. I was going to do it this afternoon, but I might save it for Sunday. I might save it for over the weekend, perhaps. Maybe even tonight. We'll see. We'll see what happens. But that's a pretty cool looking set. I'm going to have to get the Conveyx. Train set as well. Lego Star Wars train set. But this set comes with Kira, comes with Val, two of Dryden's guards, and Rio. I'm really excited about the Rio minifig, but this is a cool looking set. So I'm pretty happy with that one. So I did ask for the Conveyx Lego set as well, but she just obviously decided to jump in with the Vader helmet, which is awesome. I've been eyeing that off for a little while. I also did plan on doing an episode tomorrow morning, being Saturday, Lockie's going to come up, and we were going to record, but I'm having some dramas with my audio set up here and recording. Hopefully I've got the problem solved. I've just ordered a couple of cables, which I think may help. It's just the USB interface with the mixer doesn't quite do what I need it to. So hopefully a little bit of fiddling around, some extra cables, that should help, and we can get on with that properly next time. That was the problem we had a few weeks ago when we recorded for nearly 2 hours and then there was no audio in the file, so that really bummed me out, and I don't want to make that mistake again. So, I mean, always, that taught me a strong lesson, that's to check everything before we start, and unfortunately I did in that time. I thought it was good to go, but it wasn't. Never mind, we'll learn to do it properly next time. So, it's going to be a good weekend. It's really windy today. We just had some really hot days here in Adelaide. And got up to 36 degrees Celsius yesterday in the city, so it's probably 34 up in the hills where I am. I live up in the Adelaide Hills. We had some thunderstorms last night. They were pretty full on. There's a lot of lightning and stuff sort of around midnight to 3 in the morning-ish. And today, since it's been sort of nice and sunny, and a nice sunny day today, but it's been really, really windy. So I've been trying to hang washing out, and it's blowing all over the place. Not really Star Wars related stuff, but that's okay. I just wanted to chat a little bit today. I know there's been a little bit of news, a little bit of toy news coming out of a couple of toy fairs and stuff in conventions over in Europe. But if we get some time to record tomorrow, we'll chat about them tomorrow. But today, just wanted to kick back and talk a little bit. So keep it nice and casual. Now I'm looking forward to Sunday Supernova. Is Supernova Comic Con is going to be hitting here in Adelaide. It's here on Saturday as well, but because I'm going to be at home doing family stuff, we're going to go on Sunday, which is going to be cool. Ray Park was going to be coming earlier on in the announcements. He had to cancel and pull out, so about 2 or 3 weeks ago he pulled out, so that was a bummer. I was meant to meet him. I bought tickets to meet him at Celebration last year in Orlando. But unfortunately, the day I'd organized to do it was the same day I'd organized to book in my tattoo. And the tattoo took a lot longer than it sort of expected to, so I didn't get time at the end to then go into jump in line to meet Ray Park and Sam Witwer too, which I was hoping to meet both of them. But unfortunately, yeah, like I said, that didn't fall through. So I was really looking forward to Ray Park coming down to a little old Adelaide in South Australia and being able to have a chat with him and tell him about how I missed out and seeing him in Orlando. It would have been cool just to strike up a little bit of a chat with him. But never mind. Next time, maybe in Chicago, we'll see. But a little bonus is that Timothy Zahn is coming again. That's someone else we wanted to meet at Celebration, and we had something else on that particular morning when he was going to be signing, and when we got to his line, it was ridiculous. There were so many people in line, and the book, the Thrawn book that had just come out, was selling out really, really quickly. Like, they hadn't allotted an amount, they didn't have a very large amount for sale at the convention, so didn't really worry about that. So I was a little bit bummed out, but again, he's coming down here, which is fantastic. I've bought myself a copy of the 20th anniversary of the Heir to the Empire hardcover, so I'm going to get him to put his squiggle on that. That'd be cool. So I'm looking forward to meeting Mr. Zahn. That'd be fantastic. Hopefully, I have a bit of a chat with him too, if he's not too busy and the lineup's not too big. So I did think about trying to get into the media side of the convention and maybe try and get an interview with him, but it's still early days here at Star Wars, go figure. So I thought I'd sit on it and let this build up a little bit and get some more experience with talking and stuff, because I'm still not heaps confident. But having the YouTube, like I've said before, having the YouTube channel for years has definitely helped with my talking and stuff like that. But again, still not totally confident, so we'll give it another time, and maybe we'll go on the road on Chicago and see what we can do there. Hopefully I can have a chat with some international friends once I'm over there. So yeah, it's gonna be good fun. I'm looking forward to Supernova. That'll be Sunday. I've got some flyers to hand out to people. I'm just gonna hold them up to the camera. So I did get a bunch of these printed. So they've just got all the links to all my social bits and pieces. So I've sort of got a few of them to hand out. I've got t-shirts made up. So I'm gonna be wearing my Star Wars Go Figure t-shirt. My wife's gonna wear one as well, which is awesome. And Lockie's going to wear one too, so he's going to be representing, which is fantastic. I'm really, really pumped for that. And I did get another t-shirt printed during the week, which is cool. I can't wait to... I shared an image of it on my Instagram. It's a Ramones-inspired Star Wars t-shirt, Star Wars design that I made up for the first order. So that was kind of fun to put together, dabbling around in Photoshop. What else have I got up to this week? I did get the new SH Figure Arts Anakin Skywalker from Revenge of the Sith. I just did a review of that during the week too. I did a review of it yesterday. So that's uploaded on the channel on YouTube, so check that out. I've had some good feedback. It was a much better figure than I was expecting, so I'm looking forward to getting the Obi-Wan next. And aside from that, it's going to be starting to get into the Christmas rush. It's going to be hard to find time to do the podcast, but I'll still get it done. We'll still get them out there, still get episodes out there. Got no new figures on the horizon. I'm going to do some video reviews of some of the 3¾-inch stuff that's come out over the last couple of months. So I'm excited to sit back and record that. Hopefully pick up some new Lego sets. Like I said, the Conveyor train set would be sweet. I'm looking forward to getting that one, and I really want to get that Porg. You know, the Porg that's come out recently, it's a bit like the BB-8, and we've had the RTD2. They come with the plaque. I think the Porg comes with a plaque, I'm not sure. But I'm going to try and pick that one up in the next couple of weeks. I did buy some vintage figures off a friend at work. He come in one day. I'm just gathering some Star Wars thoughts, and I thought I'd share them here. So, yeah, anyway, back to this story. A bloke came into work. He works in the maintenance part of work, and he was telling me he knows I'm a Star Wars fan. He knows I've got a room full of Star Wars stuff. And he come up and he says to me, "Oh, look, I went up into the roof on the weekend. Went up and doing a bit of clean up of his house, doing a bit of a spring clean, and he found his vintage Star Wars stuff from when he was a kid. You know, He's probably 10 or more years older than I am, so he was at the ripe age for vintage stuff. So he'd probably be in his mid-40s, I guess. I'm not 100% sure. He may even be older than that. He may even be closer to 50. I'm not sure. I don't really have any idea. But anyway, he's at that age where he had the toys when he was a kid. And he had them stored away for a long time. He let his kids play with them when they were younger. And then they just got put back in storage. And he basically said, "Oh, I found him," and, you know, telling me a few things of what he's got. And, "Oh, you know, that's cool." He put him up on Gumtree. And he'd had a couple of messages, like, you know, people offering him $120. And I said, "Oh, mate, if you want to get rid of him, I'll fling some cash your way. And I'll take him off your hands if you want a nice, easy transaction. And, you know, I'll bring in the cash, you bring in the goods, and we'll do a straight-up swap." So He let him go to me for $60. He knew they were going to a good home, so he was quite happy to do a deal for me. So that was cool. I got some cool stuff. I got the Rebel Hoth base. It's just missing the top. I need another leg for the probe droid, and the head for the probe droid, and the little stand that it sits on, because there's a little lever that makes him swing around or pop up and down. I can't think of what it does, but that's pretty cool. Got some figures, some better versions of figures that I've got. There's a nice Bespin Luke. There was a Bespin Han, which is better than mine, but one of his kids had, like, shaved his ears off. I'm not sure why, whether they were trying to get a helmet to fit or something, I'm not sure. But I don't know why he had his ears shaved off. Like, it looked like literally a knife had, like, carved his ears off. So I thought that was quite strange, but, you know, apart from... I would have swapped it out for mine, but, you know, it's buggered, so... I'll keep it for a rainy day. Got another Tauntaun, so I'll be passing on a Tauntaun to Lockie when he comes up tomorrow. I know he's been after a Tauntaun for a while, so hooked him up with that. And yeah, a few other figures. Okay, there was another Snaggletooth, Hoth, Leia, Hoth, Luke. I can't think of the others off the top of my head. I think there was another Ugnaught. I can't remember. Anyway, it was pretty well worth the $60. I was really happy with that purchase. It's always cool when people find Star Wars stuff and they think of me, which is, you know, I'm pretty open about my Star Wars fandom these days. Just in general public, whereas probably even a couple of years ago, even 6 months ago, I probably wasn't quite as open about it. But it's all in good fun. And yeah, so we're going to go out tonight. I'm going to maybe get a couple of hours of Red Dead Redemption in this afternoon. I've been playing that pretty solidly throughout the week when I get a bit of time of an evening. And go out tonight with the wife and go have some schnitzel burgers, which sounds awesome. There's a new schnitzel place opened up here in Adelaide. So looking forward to checking that out. They've got plenty of them over in Melbourne, in Victoria. And it's been a few years since I was in Melbourne, but we ate there two nights in a row. So we're really excited that they've opened up a restaurant here in Adelaide. So looking forward to getting into their burgers and having a beer and taking it easy tonight. And then, yeah, we'll come home and chuck on the Jedi Council on Collider. So definitely fit some Star Wars into my day, as I try to most days. Always try and find a little bit of time for Star Wars, whether it's podcast or an audiobook. Speaking of audiobooks, I'm currently listening to The Secrets of Star Wars. It's a 24-hour audiobook. And yeah, that's really good at the moment. It's really going deep into the first chapter or two was really going back into the history of George Lucas, where he grew up, how he grew up, all this sort of stuff. Now it's really getting into the influences that he took on when he was developing early scripts, early story treatments, and it's really going through and comparing his work to Akira Kurosawa's and some of the old influences, like the old Buck Rogers and Flash Gordon, and even going back and looking at John Carter of Mars's influences and the story beats that they hit and how George took elements of them to make what Star Wars has become. And there's a lot of cool stuff in there that, without delving into books and pouring through books, you could find this stuff out. And there's even some influences in there that have given the creators of the sequel trilogy, names and stuff like that, like Dakar, the base of the Resistance at the end of The Force Awakens, or in The Force Awakens and at the start of The Last Jedi. That was based on a planet called Descartes in one of George's early treatments, which is really cool. So that's a really interesting read. I say read, it's a listen. So I've been chucking that on in the car on the way to and from work on the daily commute. When I haven't got podcasts to listen to, if I catch up on podcasts, I chuck the book on and listen to that for half an hour to and from work. So that's been pretty good. And I think that just about brings it up to date at the moment. I don't really have a lot else to talk about. You know, I could delve into the news and stuff. There's been some, action figure announcements, like I said, at some conventions over in London, Paris and Italy, I think. Or was it just Paris and Italy? I'll have to do my research before I speak about them a little bit more. But that will wrap it up, guys. I will leave it at that. And thank you very much for listening and or watching. Definitely let me know anything you want to talk about. Drop a comment and strike up a convo. That's what we're all here for. And hopefully we can keep this community nice and strong and positive and happy, happy times. Anyway, guys, I'm going to go enjoy the rest of my 31st birthday. And until my next podcast or video, may the Force be with you.